He's coming in his Edgely, which is our sister company, more or less. They're right down the road, and we operate all together. On this rare occasion, Rescue 10 has beat our rescue into our own district. They're going to go in service on one vehicle. Our rescue, which is right behind them, is going to go in service on the second one. The last piece following it up is the engine. Their sole function on this is to provide fire suppression. What they're going to do is they're going to put a charge hose on it. And if any fire breaks out, it's their job to put it out of the fire hose and potential victims in the vehicle as well. One of the first things they want to do is they want to take the first step through the area and take a look and see what's going on. They will check on still fuels, they will check on the patients and the injectors. Next, they want to ascertain the condition of the patients. And what they're going to do is they're going to stabilize the vehicles. You're going to see them putting blocks of wood under the cars. They're going to be using special struts to brace it so it won't fall over. And what this does, hopefully, is a it helps to prevent any further damage to the patient inside the vehicle. Because while we're working, we're cutting the car apart and stopping the door, it's still producing a move. So we're trying to stay well and stay
well.
Some of the tools being used in the vehicle are separate from the cabinet. Now, if it's used as a spreader, which does exactly that. It's spreading. These absorb so much pressure that they can spread other parts. That's their function. Now, one of the first things you want to do is generally hopefully the money you want to see when they're working on the patient.
Go, man! Let's cut!
Cover the patient so that any breath can come in on them. It's okay.
Thank you.
crews working on the blue car trying to get the door popped. The crew from Levittown Firefighter number 2 is working on a maroon car. What they're going to do is they're going to slap in the roof. Since the car is on its side, it's limited access. If I go in this again, it's going to just stay out. As I was saying, if the patient is injured severely, then they may fly medevac. Medevac is short for air medical evacuation. That's what we're hoping Pennsylvania will be showing up with CNC to get an idea of the problem. It's more or less an air ambulance. Same thing as what's on the ground. It's a little bit more compact. That's the patient's injury. And as you can see, it appears to be a patient out of the MD. Now, the first guy working on the green car with that's known as Maul's Knot, they previously had to move to that steering wheel to make better
Yeah.
We also use a variety of hand tools also. Right now, the guys are working with a saw saw. It's a simple tool. A lot of people have them in their hands. A lot of people work with some stuff now. But they prove them not useful for us on the fire ground as well. They're small, they're compact, and they're very easy to work. Now, it also could be as simple as using a lower set of tools. Wrenches, screwdrivers. It's in the severe cases like this one that we need to break up the tools.